Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we are going to be looking at my January play box. Alright guys, so it's that time once again to look at my monthly play box by Sephora. This is a monthly subscription box for sample makeups by Sephora. I also have a few new products that I got from Sephora and a funny story that I went into Sephora drunk, oh my god, and got some things that I probably wouldn't have gotten sober. And then I also want to talk about past products from my past boxes and what I thought of them. So let's just get into it. Last month's video went kind of long, so. Alright, so we open it up and here is the play card. You can go in during the month that you get the box, so I have to go in before January's over, and you can get expert advice as well as 50 extra Beauty Insider points when you buy something in the month that you get it. This is the informational, wow. Like this, whatever smelly is in here, it smells. So this is the informational on all the products in the box. I'll let you guys take a peek. Oh, I guess there's both on both sides. I thought like, oh, I won't look, but you guys can look. And then, anyways, I did take a peek at this like a few days ago, but I totally forgot what's in it. So this bag actually is like see-through on the back. I like how they are like putting more effort into their baggies. It's so cute. This says, sweat is just another way to glow. So this is like the new year, new me bag, because it's in January. Also, it is $10.82 a month with tax for me where I live. For this, so let's just get into it. I usually end with the smelly, so I'll start with the smelly, and wow, it really smells really strong. This is Love Relentlessly by Tory Burch. Wow, it smells so good. Mm, it's really freaking strong. Mmm, like I always say, I'm actually really not picky with smells as long as I don't smell like a dude. Next, we have a Clinique. What is it though? A lipstick? Is it a lipstick? Check out this color. That's super, super dark, like a purple plum color. Also, Manicure by Jazz, a cake pop color. Love it. I'm gonna read the little informational real quick to find out. I'm pretty sure this is a lipstick, but we shall see because I don't want to just assume. But it is Almost Lipstick in Black Honey. Sheer lip color with a glossy finish in the best-selling cult classic Black Honey shade. Ooh, so I guess I'll go ahead and swatch it for you guys. I could have read on the bottom, but it's really tiny writing and I'm practically blind what this color is. This is a really dark color. Oh, it's not coming out very dark. Like, it looks way darker on the stick, but it is really sheer. So what? I wonder what that would look like on my lips. It is like so sheer, you almost can't even tell. So that is the Black Honey color. I don't know. I'd have to put it on my lips to really know if I'd like it or not, but I like dramatic lip color. I am wearing, what am I wearing? I don't even remember what the name of this is, but I got it last month and I love it. It is a Smashbox. Next we have Pharmacy Honey Potion. Renewing Antioxidant Hydration Mask. Woo, I'm not against it. I do want to smell it though. I do have some skin stuff to talk about. Oh, of course it would land sticky side down. Doesn't really smell like anything, which is actually a plus for me if it's anything going on my face, which hydration mask, it's going to be going on my face, which my face has not been cooperating lately. I don't know why. Next, I have the, what, how do you say that again? Oahu? I'm pretty sure it's the name of like somewhere in Hawaii. This is a treatment mask. So this is another facial mask, I am guessing. Yep, it is. So let's see what, oh, idiot, Tia, read faster. This is for your hair. So this is a hair, and it fucking says hair care. Wow, I can't read. Okay, love anything to do with hair because look at my poor hair is so dead from bleaching it. Which actually my last video that I did for Sephora Play in December, I believe I still had bleach blonde hair, but I decided to let my natural grow out, which is a darker, dirtier blonde, dirty blonde. And so, and I left the ends bleach blonde because this is really dark for me. But yeah, and I went a little hard on the makeup today. Wow, Tia. Like, things, my face and when I put my makeup on in my bathroom looks so different from when I get in front of my filming lights. Dang, I should just like do my makeup in front of my filming lights from now on. Next, I got a Tarte Friction Stick Exfoliating Cleanser. What? Huh? Oh, there's like two little lids. Doesn't smell like anything, but there's the product. Weird. Let me read about this one real quick for you guys because I've never seen anything like it. Exfoliating gel cleanser in a unique twist-up stick format transforms from a solid gel to a cleansing lather that gently sloughs away impurities. Cool. Lots of facial matte, like, you know, new year, new me, hydrating, healthy crap in this one. Okay, next. I like when my Sephora play boxes come with more makeup versus skincare and hair care products, just because I don't really have that bad of skin. My number one issue with my skin is that I have dry skin in these areas on my cheeks, and then I get pimples mainly in this area. That's like my main issues with my skin, other than it being very, very sensitive. So, more makeup, please. Anyways, I got the Amore Pacific Color Control Cushion Compact. Huh. Tan blush, almond blush, and they're like these little things. What? And the one for pink undertones, which is me. Let me read about this one, too, because, again, never seen anything like this. So, it is Cushion Format CC Cream, hydrates, protects skin, and delivers buildable weightless coverage in two blendable shades. Oh, so it's like a cover-up. I'm definitely going to be trying this. That's awesome. So I got two, like, makeup things in this box, and then the rest was facial creams and hair treatment, which is fine. So that's all of my January play box by Sephora. Let me know what you got in your box or if you've used any of these products that I just showed, because I've never used any of those ones. And now I'm gonna go on to the story of, no, first I'm going to talk about past products that I got in my boxes, because I like to update you guys when I try stuff on how I like it or not. And then I'll go on to new products that I got. Okay, the first thing I want to talk about, this actually I didn't get in a past box. I got this for a birthday, my little free birthday gift that you get from Sephora, and it's a Marc Jacobs wax eyeliner pencil. And I'm usually against like wax eyeliner pencils because they just don't really seem to get dark enough, they don't stay on as well as liquid. And so I decided, I was like, hey, I'll use it this time. And you can see my wing is a lot thicker than normal, and I did have to go back over it with my liquid liner to make it super black. But this is pretty good black, like solid black. But like I said, the application of it is so, the little pencil tip is just so thick that I sometimes want a thinner liner, and you can't do it with this. So I was like using this for today's makeup, and I was like, I should talk about this since I'm doing the video. Also, I believe I got this in January. It's January. I believe I got this in November's box. This is the Glam Glow Thirsty Mud Hydrating Treatment. And I use this, and I think I like it. I've only used it twice because you're only supposed to use it 2 to 3 times a week. And when I use things even less than what they recommend because of my facial skin, like I give my face a good amount of time to like recover from anything. But I really kind of think I liked how it helped my patchy dry skin areas on my cheeks. But it did make my face very, very red and pretty warm the first time I used it. And I have like a little bit of clips that I want to show you from, like, because I used it and I was like, wow, so I need to record this to show you guys. So I'll show you guys that clip now. But I do want to say that it didn't hurt, it never stung or burned or anything. It was just my skin was very red and my face was very warm, which could be a natural reaction to hydrating mud masks. I don't know, because this is like the first one I used. But I will say that also my skin absorbed all of it. Like, there was no leftovers to wipe away.
Now before you freak out, I am not naked, and this is normally what my face does after a hot shower, but this seems a lot more red than usual. It doesn't hurt. It's a little warm, but it's right after using this Glam Glow Mud Mask. It's a thirsty mud hydrating treatment, and you leave it on for 10 to 20 minutes, and then you wipe it off or massage it in. I don't know if this is a normal reaction. Maybe mine might be expired. I don't know. It was kind of like I had to poke it because the first layer from like coming out of it was like coagulated. I don't know what you'd call it. So anybody got any advice? Excuse my pimple nation down there, but yeah. So we'll check back in 5 minutes and see if the redness has gone down. Like I said, it doesn't hurt or anything. It's a little bit warm right here, which is my driest area on my face, and it's already like, it was pretty thick, not a thick layer, but it felt pretty thick, and it's already like my skin has like soaked it in. It's like already pretty much almost completely dry. So this is why I wear cover up. Just kidding. My skin is not like this all the time. It's just right after the shower. But I do have a bit of red skinness that I usually prefer to cover up with liquid foundation. So, yeah. I don't know. We'll see. Right. See, it's been probably 10 to 20 minutes since I recorded. I'm not sure. But redness has definitely gone down. There's no more heat. This is totally normal redness for me. After a hot shower, my face stays pretty red for a while. I don't know why, but my face is like pretty much dry. It is like just barely sticky, but it feels good. Like, I think like you're supposed to use it 2 or 3 times a week, so I think I definitely need to use it more before I feel like a real effect from it. But no like bad reaction to it, because I'm always really cautious about putting things on my face, and when my face was super red from it, I was like, oh my gosh. But we'll see. Check back in with you guys probably next month.
So yeah, that was that. I am gonna continue to use that little thirsty mud mask hydrating Glam Glow product until it's gone, because it hasn't had any adverse effects, and if anything, I think that it has helped. So I'm gonna keep using it. Next, I want to talk about all three of these primers that I've gotten past box. This one is the Makeup Forever Step 1 smoothing primer that I got in last month, and then before that I got the Cover FX Luminating Primer, and then before that I got the Smashbox Pore Minimizing Primer. Now, I honestly think that these all work well. I think that this one does work for pores, and I get my biggest pores are like right in here because I used to be a smoker, and so those are where my biggest pores are. So that does work with pores, but I feel like sometimes my cover up over that is a little bit more splotchy than this. You can see that I have squeezed the light. There's still some in there and I'm gonna get all of it, but I've squeezed the life out of this. This is a smoothing primer, and I really think it works for like a very smooth base for your foundation. So my skin is very smooth and is way less patchy than this one, but it doesn't minimize my pores, so you can still see my pores. And then this one, I feel like I really like the way this feels. Like, it's a, these are both more like cream, like thicker creams, like clay almost, and this one is more just like a cream, like a liquid. It's way liquidy, and I like the way that feels. It does take longer to dry, like you have to dry it, but it's an illuminating primer, and I'm actually wearing this one today. I don't know if I notice enough of it being like illuminating my face or not, but I just do like the way this one feels. So I mean, honestly, I think even though this was the first one I ever used, and I did buy a big bottle of it, and I am gonna finish it, I feel like these two are better than this one, and I feel like, obviously, this one is almost all the way empty. I like this one just because my cover-up is so much more smooth on my face. Like, I can look in a magnifying mirror and not see, like, the patchiness that I would get with this one. And you know what? The Glam Glow Mud Mask may contribute to that, because I hadn't used that up until now, and maybe that's just helping with the drier parts of my skin to keep it less patchy. I don't know, but I mean, I'm gonna use this bottle and the big bottle that I bought, because I'm not gonna waste the money, but I really do think, I don't know, I have to keep using these two and decide which one I like the best. And two other products from my past boxes, not that one, that I want to rave about. Love this dry shampoo. Detox dry shampoo. Like I said in my last video, I wash my hair maybe 3 times a week. I That does not mean I don't shower. I shower and wash my body, but I do not wash my hair every day or even every other day because it's just, I just don't. I don't, even though I should because my hair is so oily that after one day it looks so bad, so I usually always wear it up. And I've used a Suave dry shampoo before, but this works so well. So much better than the Suave shampoo. I love this stuff. Like, I am, when this runs out, which I still have plenty in here, I will be getting a big bottle of this. I love it. And it's my only high-end dry shampoo that I've ever used, so I don't have anything to compare it to otherwise besides the Suave cheaper brand, and it's better than that one, so I'm gonna continue to use it until I find something else. Then this, oh my god, I'm actually not wearing it today, but I got this in last month's box. This is the Bobbi Brown Smoky Eye Mascara, and it blows the Tarte Paint Lash mascara that I got out of the water. This is so good. I love this mascara, and I did say that probably the next one I was gonna get was gonna be the Better Than Sex by Too Faced, unless I liked this one, and I love this one, and I will be getting a full size of this one. It is amazing, and then maybe I'll try out the Too Faced, but I feel like I would wish to get a sample of the Better Than Sex before I go and buy a full bottle of it, because this is amazing, and I already know it's amazing because I gotta try the sample. It elongates my lashes, it darkens them, it doesn't clump, it doesn't create them, it doesn't like crinkle them, like they're straight, and it's amazing. I freaking love this Bobbi Brown mascara, like, oh my god. And once you know, my local Sephora doesn't have it, which sucks because I don't want to pay for shipping. And then I got this also in my box. The label art that they have for it is different now. This is the Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. I do like this. I just feel like my Makeup Forever one is lighter and I like the smell better, but this is a good, like, this is also good, so I wanted to bring that up too. But I am still mainly using my Mist and Fix by Makeup Forever, so, but this is not bad, and you can, I mean, it's almost gone, so I've used it enough to like pick which one I liked out of either of them. They both work as well as far as like long lasting, but I like, I'm talking about like the feel and the weight and the smell like of it, I prefer the Mist and Fix spray. And one more thing, I did open this in my last Playbox video. This is actually a Jeffree Star cosmetic product. This is a liquid lip, and it's Dream House, and it's beautiful. It's Jeffree Star, so it doesn't really have anything to do with Sephora Play, but I wanted to bring it up because it's makeup. Not impressed. I mean, I was really, really rooting for this, and I was not impressed. And it's so pretty, but it's kind of gritty, and I was reading up on it because I was like, oh my god, like, this is a Jeffree Star product. Why isn't it blowing my mind? Because everybody else likes them. And I read that, like, sometimes with the glitter, like, how it is, kind of creates that cakey, gritty feeling. So I'm still gonna use it. Like, I'm gonna give it more shots. Like, I'm gonna maybe get like a lip primer. Does that exist? I'm pretty sure it does. There's primers for everything. But just upon my first and second use of it, I was like, mm. And so I've only used it 2 times in the month that I've had it since you guys saw me open it, because, you know, it's a really intense color. So there's not many occasions where you can just, oh, I'm gonna wear this. Like, it doesn't go with everything. Like, it's really like a, you know what I'm trying to say, like, it's out there for a lip color. It's really bright, really in your face. And so I've only used it 2 times, and I'm not like in love with it. Like, I wasn't rushing to buy the other colors, but maybe I'll try like the matte colors versus like these metallic pretty sparkly colors. I don't know, but I'm not in a hurry because I really like the Smashbox Always Matte, or Always On Liquid to Matte. Is it always matte? It's liquid to matte, and I love them, and I bought another color, which is coming up in the next little section right here. I'll show you these 3 new products that I got, and yes, you know me, I have to keep them in the box until I show you guys. And then I'll show you the products that I bought when I went into Sephora drunk, which I'm pretty mad at myself. So the first one is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Clear Brow Gel, and I got this in a sample, and I already said that I loved it, and I finally got a full bottle of it, so I just wanted to show you guys, like, I really freaking love that clear brow gel enough to buy a full bottle of it, and now I can throw away the packaging, because I'm so weird that I keep the packaging until these videos show you guys. Bam, I love it, I love it. I swear by this to keep my brow hairs tamed. And then I got another liquid lip by Smashbox, and this is the Bang Bang color. It's a red lip, which I was talking about really, really wanting. Right now I'm wearing a really bright pink lip. I don't know, I can't remember what the name is. Dream Huge. No. No, this is Shockaholic. This is Shockaholic. And the Dream Huge is the lighter shade. I only have three because they're $24, so. But I'll go ahead and swatch this for you guys, because I freaking love it. But again, a red lip is something you can't really wear all the time. But look at that. Wow, look at how much more that stands out than that other color. So there's the red. Ooh, that would have gone good with what I'm wearing today. Look. Oh. But yes. Oh, I love it. So I finally got my red in this, and this just, they just stay on. They don't come off when you eat, talk, drink, and they stay on all freaking day. They might get on my teeth sometimes because I talk a lot, but just gotta keep checking the mirror. And then I ran out of the Kat Von D Lock It Cream Concealer, and I wanted to try a new concealer. So I finally threw away this box. And I wanted to do the Born This Way Cream Concealer. This is in Fair, I believe. Yep, in Fair. And I love it. It's way lighter weight than the Kat Von D Lock It Cream Concealer. And so I really like this because my foundation is Too Faced. Now my concealer is Too Faced. So I think that they just pair well with each other. So that's what I got. And I love, love this. Okay, so the moment you guys have all probably been waiting for, my drunk story. So my girlfriend and I, like, were just having a couple glasses of wine. And then it was, like, early. So it was because I went to Sephora when it was still open. It was probably going to close in, like, half an hour. But I went and it was still open. And I probably had, like, 4 glasses of wine, but like big glasses of wine. So I was definitely feeling good. And I went into Sephora, and I've said this before in my videos, like, I wish I would have gotten the Becca Moonstone highlighter, which I'm actually using right now. And girl, it's so bright, like brighter than my future. And I love it. I do love it way more than the highlighter that I bought on the recommendation of the girl in Sephora, which was the Makeup Forever, I believe. And it's just so much better. So, Drunk Tia goes into Sephora because I love to go into Sephora and just like see if there's anything new or like pick up something I heard about. And so, look what I bought. And I'm pretty sure this was $40. This is the Pressed Moonstone, and it is beautiful. I am going to use the rest of that other highlighter because they're both like in the $30 to $40 range, but oh my gosh, look at it. It's just so pretty, so beautiful. Hey, look, there you guys are. Ooh, Inception. So yeah, Drunk Tia spent her money on something she didn't need. But it is so much better than the other one. But like I said, I'm still gonna use the other one. And then I was like thinking about how I, again, took the recommendation of the girl at Sephora and got the Kat Von D Lock It Translucent Setting Powder because they were out of the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. And that's the one everybody talks about. And so I was just like in there and I was like, hey, you guys have that in yet? And she's like, well, we do, but we don't. I should learn to turn that off. Honestly, that's a reminder for me. It's been on my phone for weeks. It was when I was sick, and it would remind me to drink water because I was so sick that I would sleep a lot and not drink enough water and be dehydrated. And so that's what that is. And I just haven't turned it off because then I'm like, it reminds me in the middle of the day, and I'm like, oh, maybe I should drink some water. Or I'm like, oh, shut up, I'm drinking water right now. Anyways, back to the story. So they don't have the full size. They only ever carry the sample size. And Drunk Tia is like, yeah, I'll get it. I want it. And so I got it, and it's cute, but it's not practical for baking and stuff. And it does come with this little floofy, but because I don't use it as a, like a, excuse me, I got an itch right there. Because I don't use it as like a traditional setting powder, I have like a 110 setting powder color. I use this for baking specifically under my eyes, and I also noticed that I really have to set the top of my eyes. And so it's really hard to get my beauty blender in there to get the powder out. But it is so much better than the Kat Von D Lock It Translucent Setting Powder, because I mentioned how it kind of leaves like a white like a brighterness under my eyes, and this one doesn't, and it's totally just amazing. So, I mean, these purchases, they're upgrades from what I have, in my personal opinion, but they were unnecessary because I have these types of products already that I need to use before I get more, and I'm probably not going to be buying anything else new except for maybe the Bobbi Brown mascara, because I have everything now and I need to use what I've bought. The only other things I can think of that I would really like to buy is like maybe some really nice brushes, because I have super super China cheap brushes right now. But that's not even the worst purchase I made while I was drunk in Sephora. Are you guys ready for it? I was so mad in the morning. I was like, oh my god, why did I buy that? I'd been meaning to buy new tweezers for a while, because I've had these certain set of tweezers for since like high school or earlier, I mean at least for sure high school. And so drunk Tia thought it was a great idea to buy Anastasia Beverly Hills Precision Tweezers. So they come like this, and then they come out like this, and they're cute, they're pink, and they have this little protective tip that I am gonna keep, because I'm pretty sure that lengthens the life of your tweezers. I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure. Guess how much these were, because I'm so mad. They were more expensive than the Anastasia Beverly Hills clear brow gel that I got. These were $28 frickin' dollars. I almost cussed, but I'm really trying not to cuss as much anymore. $28 for tweezers. I'm so mad at myself. Like, you don't need high-end tweezers, Tia. Like, what was I thinking? I wasn't thinking. I was thinking on a brain of wine. Like, so that's a lesson learned. I am no longer allowing myself to go into Sephora after I've had a couple glasses of wine. Anyways, this video, like all of my Sephora Play videos, has ran very long, so I'm gonna let you guys go. Comment down below all the stuff about makeup. I would love to chat with you guys. If you have any ideas on primers or setting sprays, those are kind of into that right now. Like, wanna find a good one. Just let me know down in the comments, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.